We now welcome George and Cindy Anthony, the grandparents of the missing Florida toddler, Caylee Anthony. They last saw her in mid-June. How are you holding up?
We take one day at a time. You know, it's very hard. A lot of sleep loss. Lost a lot of weight. You know, we just take one day at a time.
When did you last see Caylee?
I last saw her on June 16th, the day after Father's Day.
What happened the day she went missing?
We actually didn't find out until July.
She'd been missing how long when you found out?
About a month.
Isn't that strange?
Not really. My daughter, you know, had her, and, you know, we just assumed that Casey and Caylee were, you know, off visiting friends.
George, why wouldn't your daughter call you and say, Caylee's gone?
That's really a good question. I know we kept in contact with her, at least Cindy did, almost every day or every other day. A little text message here and there, everything was fine.
So what do you make of it? I mean, she's your daughter, you have to have some. Yeah. Why would she not tell you?
I think she was frightened. I think from what we understand that, you know, there's been threats to not only Caylee's well-being, but also to our family's well-being.
By
the people that have Caylee.
So you think Caylee was taken? Your daughter obviously knew she was taken. Mm-hmm. For what purpose?
You know, I'm still trying to sort that out. You know, the person that originally has her or had her, we've had three or four different sightings with the same description that Casey released, that they finally released on this person. And the Zaneta that the police department tracked down was one out of thousands that Casey said right from the beginning was not the correct person. They just now released, within a couple weeks ago, the actual description of the babysitter. And we've had three that I'm aware of, tips that have come in since June, that people describe this person to a T that had Caylee.
What does your daughter think, George?
Well, our daughter thinks that Caylee needs to be found, and she said...
What does she think happened?
Well, she's already told us that this Zanny, this babysitter, is one that has her.
Who denies it?
Well, the one at the, like Cindy just said, about the one at the sheriff's department, our local sheriff's department, had brought to my daughter's attention, it's not her.
Now, let's go back to July 15th. Cindy, here's part of the 911 call that you made.
911, what's your emergency?
I called a little bit ago, the deputy sheriff's son, and I found out my granddaughter has been taken. She has been missing for a month. I told you my daughter was missing for a month. I just found her today, but I can't find my granddaughter. And she just admitted to me that she's been trying to find her herself. There's something wrong. I found my daughter's car today, and it smells like there's been a dead body in the damn car.
Did you suspect your daughter?
No.
Never in
Never.
All of this?
Never.
Never. I have not. From day one, I haven't. You know, Casey has been a loving, very caring mother. And I could see that first night that she was very frightened when the sheriff's department arrived at the house. I mean, she was devastated. She was on the floor just beside herself. And she has been very emotional since day one, which hasn't been reported. Her main focus has been, as same as ours, has been looking for Caylee since the very beginning.
When they arrested her, were you shocked, George?
Oh, absolutely. When they took her into custody the very first time, I was just appalled because I wanted them to, number one, put an Amber Alert out for my granddaughter, which they never did. They never contacted the FBI that I wanted them to contact. I mean, I have a little bit of knowledge in some stuff, and you would really think that they'd want to have some, someone wanting to have help them assist trying to find a beautiful 3-year-old girl. And all I was trying to do was trying to help them, and they haven't.
Why do you think they wouldn't?
Had their mind made up.
They had their mind made up. You know, they picked out Zenaida Gonzalez. They picked out a 38-year-old woman when Casey told him it was a 24-year-old woman. They picked out someone that had children.
As a nanny, you mean?
Right, and she told them she had no children. You know, they, from the very beginning, decided how this was going to take place. They made judgment on her within 2 hours of having her in custody, and that's the way it's been. They have not assisted us into looking into finding Caylee. And we believe she is alive.
I get it. I want to get to that. Have they set a trial date?
Right now, January 5th.
And no death penalty, right?
No death
they removed.
Penalty.
They had it and then removed it.
They removed
yes.
it.
You don't realize the whole United States is looking for our Caylee.
I know that, Mom.
We're back. Casey Anthony, by the way, was interviewed by members of the Orange County Sheriff's Office July 16th. Here's part of that.
Why didn't you call prior to today?
I think part of me was naive enough to think that I could handle this myself, which obviously I couldn't. And I was scared that something would happen to her if I did notify the authorities or got the media involved or my parents, which I know would have done the same thing. Just the fear of the unknown, fear of the potential of Caylee getting hurt, of not seeing my daughter again.
Why do you think she was arrested and charged, George?
Because they had to, like Cindy said, they had her mind made up. It was just too easy for them to just close the book on this and say, well, we're going to charge you with your daughter's disappearance and just be done with it.
Did they ever look at why a mother would kill a daughter? I mean, did anyone ever question motive?
Right. There is no motive, and they haven't found a motive. They even said they haven't found a motive. They told us they thought it was an accident, and she's scared, and she's trying to cover it up.
Killed her by accident and then like,
right.
buried her or something.
They don't feel there's a motive.
Have they looked for the child?
We've had 5 searches done by the Sheriff's Department, done by Tim Miller with Texas Equisearch.
I know him.
And it's come up with nothing. There's nothing that they have found that, you know, has given them any evidence that Caylee is no longer with us.
Where do you think she is, George?
Oh, Caylee? She's with, hopefully, a loving family and just taking good care of her.
We got a tip today.
Today?
Today, at 4 o'clock today. Right now, being investigated by...
What was the tip?
In Tennessee.